Hello friends, welcome back in my YouTube channel Wide Loop Robotic and Automation. Today we are going to learn how to develop a DC driver for STM32F4 Nucleo board by using resistor manipulation. So let us get started step by step. This is circuit diagram. Here you can see I am using potentiometer. Middle pin of potentiometer is connected to A0 pin and first pin of potentiometer is connected to 3.3 volt. And third pin of potentiometer is connected to ground. Okay, if I will rotate this potentiometer, then middle pin will provide variable voltage up to 3.3 voltage. So we are going to make driver so we can read this voltage. Okay, so we will go to Kill IDE. This is our previous program of user TXRX driver. So I will create here new project. And new folder, basic ADC. Okay, here we will select controller name. So STM32F411RE and select this. Okay, and select here SIMSys core and go to device, here select startup and okay, and I will rename this STM32F4. And this is app. Okay, I will add here main.c file. So select here c and name is main added. Okay, here I will type program. So first of all go to target option and here select 16 megahertz and compiler version 5, debug is stlink debugger. And go to settings, here change, reset and run. Okay, then okay, great. Now I will start programming. So first of all we will add here header file of STM32F4 Nucleo board. So has include STM32F4X.h. okay, and int main, it is void. Okay, and here I will use while loop. Okay, it is void. First of all I will create function for ADC initializing. So it will be void ADC underscore init and void. Okay, so now we will go to reference manual and dataset. So I will open here first dataset, zoom it. Okay, and go to block diagram, search here. Okay, this is block diagram. So we will use here ADC1. You can see ADC1 is connected on APB2 bus. Okay, so we have to enable APB2 clock source. Okay, and I am using PA0 pin, so we have to enable AHB1 bus because of port A is connected to AHB1 bus. Okay, so first of all we have to enable AHB1. So go to reference manual I will open here reference manual, zoom it and go to RCC resistors. This is AHB1 ENR. Okay, here we have to enable port A, so 0th bit will be 1. Okay, so I will type here RCC arrow AHB1 ENR OR operator 1 left shifted by 0. Okay, now we will go to mode register. Now I will close this data sheet. Okay, and go to mode register. Mode register, go to GPIO registers, and here it is mode register. I am using here PA0 pin. Okay, so we have to enable PA0 pin as a analog. So you can see if it will be 1 1, then it will work as an analog input. Okay, so first and 0th bit will be 1 1. So if it is 1 1, so in decimal form it will be 3. GPIO A arrow mode register OR logic, it is 3 left shifted by 0. Okay, now we have to enable the clock source for ADC1. So again RCC, and ADC1 is connected to APB1 bus, so APB1 ENR. Okay, and OR logic, we will go to APB1 ENR registers. So it is in RCC. APB1 ENR. Okay, ADC1 is connected to APB2 bus, so we have to enable APB2. So you can see here, so 8th bit will be 1 to enable ADC1. You can see here it is printed. If it is 0, so ADC1 clock disabled. If it is 1, so ADC1 clock, sorry, here it is misprinting. So if it is 1, so ADC1 clock will be enabled. Okay, so it is 1 left shifted by 8. Okay, now we will go to ADC CR1 registers. It is ADC control registers. So this is ADC registers. So first of all, we will set ADC resolution. So these 24 and 25 bit dedicated for resolution. I will use here 10 bit. So it will be 0, 1. Okay, so 25th bit will be 0 and 24th bit will be 1. Right. So here 24 bit will be 1 for 10 bit ADC. Right. So ADC 1. CR1 and OR logic, it is 1 left shifted by 24. Right, we will go to CR2 registers. So here first we will disable the ADC by default. By default it is disabled, but we will disable in code. Okay, so this is 0th bit. You can see if AD on bit will be 0, then ADC conversion go to power down mode, and if it is 1, so it will be enable. Okay, so I will keep here 0 ADC 1 CR 2 and it is 1 left shifted by 0th. So here CR2, okay, first bit will be 1, so I will use here AND operator and negate this. Okay, so ADC is disabled. Now we will go to SQR3 registers. So ADC1, SQR3. I am using here PA0 pin. So we will use here channel 0. So this bit will be 0. Okay. In case of channel 1, so 0th bit will be 1. In case of channel 2, so first bit will be 1. Okay, because of I am using channel 0, so all these bit will be 0, right? So this is simply 0. Okay, now we will turn on the ADC. So ADC1 CR2 OR logic and 1 left shifted by 0. Okay, comment this ADC on okay. Right, this function is ready, so I will copy this and paste here as a prototype function. Now I will create another function. It is ADC conversion function. So void ADC conversion. Okay, to ADC conversion we have to go to CR2 registers. So this is ADC CR2 register. CR2 is nothing, it is just control register 2. So here we can see 30 bit, it is SWRT, so start conversion of regular channel. Okay, if it is 0, so it will be in reset state. If it is 1, so it will start conversion of regular channels. Okay, so simply it will be 1 to start the conversion. So ADC1 CR2 1 left shifted by 30 position. Okay, copy this and paste here. Here it is 1. Okay, and now I will create ADC read function. So it is int ADC read वाइट, ओके। गो टू एस आर रजिस्टर, एस आर इज नथिंग, इट इज जस्ट ए डी सी स्टेटस रजिस्टर। सो हियर वी विल सी फर्स्ट बिट रजिस्टर ई ओ सी। हियर यू कैन सी रेगुलर चैनल इंड ऑफ कन्वर्जन, ओके। दिस बिट विल बी जीरो इफ ए डी सी कन्वर्जन विल नॉट कम्प्लीट, ओके। इफ ए डी सी कन्वर्जन विल कम्प्लीटेड देन इट विल बी वन, राइट। सो हियर इट विल चेक, सो आई विल यूज व्हाइल लूप एंड हियर वी विल चेक ए डी सी वन एस आर रजिस्टर्स एंड वी विल चेक फर्स्ट बिट, राइट। सो इफ इट इज वन मीन्स कन्वर्जन हैज बीन कम्प्लीटेड, ओके। सो हियर आई विल यूज नॉट लॉजिक ओके। राइट, इफ कन्वर्जन विल बी कंप्लीटेड देन फर्स्ट बिट ऑफ एस आर रजिस्टर्स विल बी वन, ओके। सो इफ इट इज वन सो इट विल बी जीरो देन इट विल बी आउट फ्रॉम व्हाइल लूप। सो हियर इट विल रीड द डी आर रजिस्टर, सो इट विल रिटर्न ए डी सी वन डी आर रजिस्टर्स, राइट। डी आर इज नथिंग जस्ट इट इज डेटा रजिस्टर। नाउ कोड इज कंप्लीटेड, आई विल कॉपी दिस एंड पेस्ट हियर, ओके। सो फर्स्ट आई विल इनिशियलाइज दिस ए डी सी, पेस्ट हियर and I will make a variable, so int it is adc data, okay, and I will call this adc conversion function in while loop, okay, and I will call this ADC read function, okay. Now I will store in ADC data variable, so ADC data, okay. So now code is ready, okay. So once I will build this code, wow, there is no errors and no warnings, great. Now uploading done. Now I will debug this, so start debugging, okay, and here select ADC data variable and right click and add to watch first, and here disable this hexadecimal display, this is int, and run this. Why it is not working? Oh sorry, here it is apb2, right, and again build this code and load and start debugging and run. Wow, you can see here it is showing value 391. So I'll rotate this potentiometer by using screwdriver, you can see value is decreasing. You can see value is increasing. This is maximum 1023 because of ADC resolution is 10 bit. Wow. So ADC is working very well. So I hope this video is very informative for you. If you really like this video, so you can support me on PayPal. My PayPal account is given in description box. Thanks for watching.